Welcome to part two of the Loonboss paint. And there we are, me sharing my paints. What they are, let's find out. So I'm starting with the wood. Let's see, Steel Legion Drab is my base. Seraphim Sepia is my shade. And I think I attempted the highlight of Carrick Stone, but I'm not really good at highlighting yet, so bear with me. Cleanups with a toothpick and a little dab of water, really convenient. So now I'm gonna try the big mushroom top. So it's Wasdaka Red, base Ricklin Flesh Shade for my shade, and I'm using Emperor's Children instead of Pink Horror for my highlight. Thank you. So I'm going to wait for this to dry and go back to the wood. And for this little tiny bit of the video, you get to enjoy channel surfing of my partner. And he's a bit noisy, but at least it's not his work meetings that you're hearing, which I generally delete. Yeah. As I wait for the wood to dry, the seraphim sepia, I'm going to go back to the mushroom. And let's see, what did I use my mushroom again? Ricklin Flesh Shade, yes. I acknowledge that my wet palette is too wet here. And White Scar for the little spots on the red mushroom top. I will say, this stuff was disgusting right out of the pot. I mean, I know I'm probably going to have to get a shaker ball for it, but I'm going to wait. So the dangly bit, the decoration, I whipped out Carrick Stone. I don't even know why I did. It's not in my notes, so I may have to update them. But it looks pretty good. Here's my sad attempt at highlighting the wood with the Carrick Stone. That's where I have it written down. And wow, not good. Now it's time for two more bases. Deep skin flesh will be the head and skin. And for the moon, it's going to be Avalon Sunset.
Oh, why do I keep doing that? Good enough. Keep hitting me. Thank you.
shading the skin with Beal Tan Green. On to shading the moon with Cassandora Yellow. And welcome. We're in the home stretch. This is assembly of the body. And probably on top of the base.
It can be open.
And the gap. Yes, I know, in his head. So I try to figure out some things, but in the end, I learned to live with it. I finished painting him off screen. Definitely liked the more leisurely pace of it. Took me 2 weeks to do him completely, and I'm really happy with him. So thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed these two videos. Thank you.